everybody, and welcome to this week's episode of Kim's Upholstery Live. We are at part 7 of our fancy club chair project. Each week we bring you a project that we're working on here in our upholstery studio. And this little baby we've been working on, like I said, this is week number 7. We started with the tear down, then we went to the deck and the arms and the back, and now we're ready to finish up the inside back and start closing up our chair. So as you come in, go ahead and say hello. Let us know where you're viewing from, if you're here on Facebook and also if you're on YouTube. If you're on YouTube and you haven't subscribed to our channel, we invite you to go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And then once you do that, a little bell icon will appear. And if you click on that as well, you'll be notified every time we go live or add new content to YouTube. So welcome to this week's episode, everybody, and thank you for joining us. And I look forward to saying hello to each of you and finding out where you are viewing from. So the main fabric on our chair is from Greenhouse Fabrics. It's from their Charisma Chenille collection. This is the F1237 color Capri that we've used for the interior. And on the outsides of the chair is this fun, dramatic looking fabric that I ordered from Spoonflower. I forget the name of the designer, but it's a black and white diamond fabric, and it's on their dogwood denim, which is a heavier denim. I think it was a 10 ounce that we'll be using for the contrast on the top of our back and then on the outsides as well. So I was really excited to work with this fabric, and when I first got it, I hadn't really thought about how it was going to land in this area that goes around the perimeter of the inside back, which is like only an inch in. Let's actually measure it and get an exact here. At the top, it's like 7/8 of an inch, and then when I get down to the sides, it's about an inch and a half. So I hadn't really thought about how the fabric print was going to land on that. And originally I was thinking I would just have like start in the center of a diamond, or you know, have a large part of the diamond on there. But then when I got playing around with the fabric and pinning it in place, I came up with this little design that looks like little tiny bow ties that we had talked about last week. So as we get to put that on, you'll see what I mean about that. But it's breaking up the fabric sort of like that. So it ends up having these little tiny looking black bow ties as you're running across the perimeter of the chair. So I'm thinking it's going to look really cool. Hopefully it'll do what I want it to do. And it'll look the way I'm expecting it to look in my mind. But we will find out once we get going. So again, as you come in, go ahead and say hello. Let us know you're here. As always, we ask if you help us out here at Kim's Upholstery. And if you like what we do, go ahead and hit that share button so that others can benefit from the education that we give as well. Looks like we've got people hopping in. I see some emotions happening and things. So I'll say hi to you as soon as I get a chance. So here we go, there they come. So we've got Susan from Annapolis, hello. And Katrina is here from Alabama, and Sherry and Allison and Janice and Sylvia and Carol and Bonnie. Hey, everybody's hopping in quick right away today. Thank you guys for all joining in. So let's go ahead and get started and see what this black and white fabric looks like. Anybody on YouTube yet, Bill, before I get started? And I see Joanne just hopped in.
Yeah, Hebert, Maria.
Hello. Hello, Hebert and Maria. And who did you say? I'm sorry.
I just said hello.
Oh, okay. All right.
Hello is here.
Hello is here. Hello, hello. All right. Enough with the silliness. Let's get going. All right. So I was going to do, actually, let me touch on another thing. I'm going to be doing this in 3 separate pieces of fabric. The reason is I didn't have, the width of the fabric is not long enough to go all the way across the top and down the sides. So I opted to have a joint at either corner, and I also thought that would be easier for me to continue the pattern flow and match things up nicely. So we will have a joint happening at the corners that will be an overlap of fabric. So let's go ahead here. I did have this marked as what was the center. There we go. This is the center of my strip, even though we're not going to need all of it. And actually, let's go ahead and trim some of this off and get it out of the way. Oh, and I should have pointed out the buttons. We'll look at those after. Let me just go ahead and trim this excess fabric all the way up and around. And I mentioned last week that I was going to go ahead and put the cording on, and I've done that just to save time. You all know how to attach cording, I imagine. So I attached the cording all the way around the perimeter of the inside back. All right, there, out of our way. Now let's get started with our strip. So again, find my center. And I've got the center marked on my chair. So I'm just gonna play around for a second, getting the width that I need. There's my center. So we're gonna have very little amounts. Move my hand so you can see. So we got very little amounts of the black showing, which forms those little black bow ties, as I'm calling them. So let's go ahead and get a staple to hold that in place and get started. And I cut the strip extra wide on purpose because I wasn't really sure how I was gonna land this print until I got to the chair and started playing.
I'm gonna move that forward about 10 inches.
The chair? Yeah.
Good.
Is that good? Okay. I think that's gonna be so cute. And if you remember, I was going for sort of an Alice in Wonderland effect for this, and I think this is definitely gonna accomplish that. I even looked on Spoonflower for fabrics that were like the decks of cards, so the different cards, but they didn't really have one in a scale that I liked, so I ended up going this route. And actually, I can see through the fabric enough to see the size of the diamonds, which are actually little triangles when they get stapled on. Let's get a few staples, and then we'll take a peek and see if I have to make any adjustments on the size or if I'm getting it accurately here, looking through the fabric. Now I'm just stapling right up behind that cording. There's my corner. All right, now my corners didn't end up exactly as I thought they would. So, let's see. Either my chair is not symmetrical or the fabric is printed a little bit different size as you go. So do I want it to end that way? Yeah, I guess it's okay, because this is, the black is in the center. We'll take a peek and decide. I thought I was gonna have a part of a white triangle on each corner, but I only have a part of a white on the left, and then I have the black almost coming to the edge on the right. So. Then we will pad this area a little bit. Add our cardboard tack strips. There's the look, you guys can see. Obviously with it not pulled completely tight, it doesn't look very neat right this moment, but that gives you an idea of the little, that gives you an idea of the triangles or the diamonds that are forming. Sorry, I'm gonna talk louder now because our air compressor just came on. But I'm still looking at the way these corners. So I'm gonna double check my measurements and make sure that my center is marked the way it should be, because it's really bugging me that it didn't end up with the same amount of white on both sides. So let's check that out. So flip this back for a minute, set my staple gun down, grab a tape measure, and a pencil. If I measure across the outside back, which you're not going to be able to see all of this, and go from side to side, I'm going to measure in a couple different spots just to see. So I'm going to go to the full width, which is 20, and then 10 is my center, and then if I go using the back post, that's 18. Yeah, I am right on the center, so. The chair shape is not consistent, so that's why I've got the more white on one side than the other. So I guess the debate is, do I want the black diamond in the center, or is it more important to have the same amount of white on each side? And I'm thinking because of the outside fabric, eeny, meeny, miny, mo, that it's probably more important to have the black in the center. I think we will go with what's happening and then continue, which unfortunately will mean they'll end up different at the bottom too.
Don't tell anybody they won't notice. It's our chair.
I know it's our chair, but it's one of those things that you have to kind of make a decision which is going to look better. What do you guys think? Diamond centered or white even? Let's see what people's vote is. If the white's even, there's still no promise that when I get to the bottom, it will land the same, because it's either the fabric that's printed differently or the chair frame could be differently down there. So what do you guys say? Center the black diamond or even the whites out? Let's see what everybody's vote is here. Hello, Annette, and hello, Jenny, and hello, Annie, and Ragnay, and Debbie, and Sandra, and Diana, and Audrey. Let's see, hello, James. Anybody commenting yet? I know it takes a minute. There's a bit of a delay, so I might not see your comment right away here. Okay, it looks like the comments are not coming in yet. White even. Okay, I'm already seeing white even, so let's go ahead and switch this. I think you guys are probably right.
Wow. Everybody's saying
white Everybody even. Said white even. Okay, so that's what I was thinking, but I'm kind of like, really? Do it? They're really important. So, all right, let's shift it. So let's see, I've got more white on this direction, so we need to shift everything to the left. So I'm going to start. Oops, don't rip the fabric, Kim. That would not be good. Did I make a hole in it? It's behind the staple, so it's okay. Pop this out. So we're gonna have to split the difference from what's there originally. So let's see, over here I have about 3/4 inch of white, and over here, I should have measured this before I took it apart. I only have 1/4 inch of white, so we should end up with about 1/2 inch on either side. Sit that down there. And I need that ruler. All right, so if I bump this over, squeak it just a hair more. Okay, that's my 1/2 inch. And I'm going to use temporary staples. Are you laughing at me, Bill?
Well, I was looking at the video on the phone and I heard the gun go off, and in the phone it showed you were shooting into the floor, but of course it wasn't.
Okay, now let's shift this other side. Inch on this side, and then if everything was planned right, it will land right in the center as far as the amount of fabric I've got, not the diamond. Okay, so now I've got my inch. Yeah, I like that much better. Good call, guys. All right, so now I'll go ahead and hit those staples the rest of the way in, and then we will add our cardboard texture. Actually, I didn't check the size of my black. Okay, this one's off a little bit over here. I did go a little wide here towards the end, so I'm going to have to move those. Got too much black hanging out. But at least I know my spacing's going to work. And I doubt you'll be able to tell that that diamond's off-center in the top. Right. Now let's concentrate on the size of our diamond here. So hello, Sharon. Nearly forgot to watch today's episode. Well, I'm glad you remembered. Sherry and David and Tony, thanks for coming in. Let's get this last one. Okay, and now let's check the other side. Okay, so this left side. Once the cardboard's in there, that'll be fine. It actually looks like I jumped out a little bit further on that end diamond again. All right, these are good. These three need to go bumped in a little. These are all those details that take time, but it's worth the effort of doing it and getting it to look the way you want it. So you take the time and the results will pay off.
Michelle McKenzie joined us on YouTube. Hello.
Hello, Michelle on YouTube. Now, as I'm working, if you guys have questions about anything, go ahead and type your questions in. And we do try to answer the questions while we're live, but once in a while I miss one and I'll answer you when I go back and review them all after the show. And Bonnie, that sofa you just put out there is absolutely beautiful with all that top stitching. Talk about a lot of work. All right. That right there. Just these last two, and I think we are ready for the next step. From the back, it looks like it's right. That's strange. No, it's not, though. Okay, the staple's not cooperating. So there we go. It was actually bent around the fabric and I didn't want it to tear the fabric. Let's see, pull it that way. Two more staples to pull. Where you have to be patient too. It's like if you hurry in and you're not in the right frame of mind, you won't pay attention to all these little details, and then later you'll be angry at yourself that you didn't take the time to fix them. All right, I think we get it. One more peek. Okay, I think we're there. Get that cardboard tack strip up there. Okay, let's go for it. All right, so I'm gonna cut off some of this excess, so I'll be folding it underneath to do our overlap. So I'll just get rid of this stuff to get it out of my way. And I wanna go ahead and get the cardboard tack strip on this portion, I think, before we add that next one, just to double check myself. Although, yeah, because I need it up on the pedestals for the rest, so it's easier to do from down here for me for this part. And I could piece two pieces of cardboard to strips together. I don't have to have it all in one strip. It will still be fine. Did you guys see that post I posted? I forget whether it was yesterday or the day before. Of that chair that Diana Hershey from DBH Designs did in the white and black fabric. And when I was there teaching the workshop, that chair had just come in, and I tell you, the design of that was really different. So it was like the Martha Washington chair, but then it had, they had actually almost made like a round skirt, like a table skirt, and upholstered it over the seat, and they had pull strips underneath, and they wanted that similar design, but the fabric they chose, obviously from the pictures you saw, I mean, it was just incredible, the fabric and the work that Diana did. It had direction, so she had to come up with a different way to do it and get the similar look to what they were looking for, and she had no wood to attach that skirt to because it was high up on the seat. So there was a lot of details that she had to consider planning that out. I think she did an absolutely spectacular job. And I think it looks much better done the way she did it rather than the original. Anyway, the original kind of was like an ugly duckling. All right, one last peek. Looking. All right, those last diamonds just seem to be wanting to squeak. You know what? Actually, what it is, I think the chair width is different there too. Let's check. So that's 7/8. What are we down to? No, we're still at 7/8. Not so much. It's this side that's bugging me. So we've got this side of the chair is almost an inch. Okay, so this side of the chair is, that's my problem. This side of the chair is about 7/8 of an inch. The top is 7/8 of an inch. But when I get over to here, my frame is 1 1/8. So that's why I'm struggling with this. So I'm just gonna have to accept that and let it go because there's no way to get them to look exactly the same when the chair width is different. So I gotta let it go. Take a deep breath, Kim. It's okay. That's gonna drive me nuts though. But that's not me, it's the chair frame. So okay, that's why it was bugging me. All right, so now let's go ahead and add our padding. Oops, I forgot to flip this back too. Gotta pop that staple. Although you know what I can do? I can go back on top of the cardboard. Now I'll just pop the staple. So sometimes there's things about furniture, the furniture frame, that you just can't control. And this is one of those. And as much as I want that to look exactly the same size as the other side, there's not much I can do about it. Unless I wanted to add wood to the frame, which we're not going to do. Leave the cardboard up in the air, and I'm gonna have Bill come over in a second and help me put this up on a pedestal, but first I gotta clean off my pedestal. So David says love the colors. I've been trying to remember for weeks to join in for the Wednesdays. Well, I'm glad you remembered. Let's see, let me move everything out of the way so that Bill and I can put this chair back up on the pedestal and then we can do the sides. So I think it'll be easier. Kirby's I can leave right underneath the chair, but everything else I'm gonna move. Things up on the pegboard. Move my staples. Okay, Bill. Now we have to think about where the cameras are. Looks like it needs to come towards me. Hair from there. There we go. All right, so now what I'm going to do is the same thing we did at the top, coming down both sides. If I planned right, I should have enough fabric for both sides. I just thought about that. I probably should cut a third strip just in case, or I shouldn't have started from the center of this one. But we'll find out. So I need the other half of the white diamond. So if I overlap, let's see, where's the black? Just looking at through the fabric underneath there. That's the edge of the black diamond. Get a temporary staple in here. See what that looks like. Probably should have started this strip with it on the blower. I think that's it. All this planning. So hello, Tasha. And Carol says, you really can't tell the black diamond is not centered, at least from the camera angle. I'm thinking that that's going to be the case, because it literally was, what, a quarter of an inch difference? And hello, Bianca. And Bonnie says, thanks for the comment on the sofa. And Bianca says, love the contrast of fabric and colors. Bonnie said, I shared my workroom Wednesday video, so I'm hoping others will share as well. I saw it, but I didn't get a chance to watch it yet. I saw it just before we went live, so I will look at that later too. Ragnay says, I can't tell by the angle, but why would you not go down the sides in one piece? Because the fabric wasn't wide enough to do both sides, so I opted to be symmetrical and have a seam at both top corners instead of just having one random seam somewhere. Brian says, you want the fabric to be going in the same direction for the inside back. I'm not sure what you mean. So all my nap is going in the same direction on the insides. And then the outside back will be this diamond pattern. David says, I'm lucky I was pulled into taking my niece and nephew into the dentist.
Oh, your niece and nephew weren't so lucky.
Your niece and nephew weren't so lucky. Sharon says, I'm Marie Kondoing my workroom as I watch. I was, and still is, a mess. It was, yeah, I know what you mean. It's like organization is no fun. And we all let it go to the point where it's like crazy. Watching from the waiting room, and Kirk says, hello Kirk, thanks for joining us. And Tasha says she loves the colors too. Yeah, this is totally not my normal colors, as you guys all know. But I don't know, there's something about these teals that I'm starting to really like. So speaking of what we've got up here, what do you think of the buttons? So I decided to go with 6 buttons. Originally I thought I was going to go with 4. And when this chair was done before, it actually had buttons in the centers too, so it was forming diamonds. And I just didn't like that. I thought it was too much. And then I also added the buttons into the arms just for a different detail. So what I did is figured out where my cushion was going to be, and then I kind of centered in the space that was left above the cushion. So I'm liking the button detail. What do you guys think? All right, back to our triangles, what you're commenting on that. So now I have to do the same thing all the way down the side. Now, on the sides of the chair, this is wider. The more I go down, the wider it is from when it starts toward the top. So my diamonds are gonna get bigger. My bow ties are gonna get bigger. So I think I'm gonna squeak it and try to make them trying to decide, do I want them to be the same size on the inside as they are on the top, or let the whole thing get bigger? I'll play with it as I go and see what I come up with here. It's one of those just deciding what looks the best. So can you guys, let's see, where can I get so you guys can see that? So if I keep the side that's up against the cording the same size as it was up here, then the outside of the diamond is going to be bigger as I get to the bottom. Or I just keep shifting it so that my two diamonds stay similar size, as close as I can get them to happen. I think that's what I want to do. Yeah, I like that. So I'm letting the diamond increase on both halves as I go down the chair. Does that make sense?
Makes sense to me.
Okay. And think that's it. So I'm going to go ahead and get a staple down here towards the bottom to hold that in place. If I can get my chair to stop moving. Let's do the same thing on the other side before we commit. How's that sound? And I think the bottoms are the same width because I did measure those before and I did not catch the top is different. So I guess I have to take some of this fabric with me, don't I? Let's hold this up. Cut it in half. So we got plenty. What did I do with my scissors? I wasn't going to cut this apart before, just in case I needed to change my game plan. Alright, so let's get the other side started. Do we want to go over here? Which is easier for the camera? Probably the other way. And then we'll get our cardboard tack strips stapled the rest of the way down. Don't need all that extra white on there. So now again, trying to find my little diamond. Getting started and getting the pieces all lined up in the right direction is probably the most time consuming. Let's get a staple right there and see what that looks like. Let's check it on the other side. You know what? I don't think I checked that over here, did I? Where's my little tape? I go from there to there. It's my 4 1/4 almost. From there. It's not really 4 1/4. I'm just using that end of the ruler, so. Almost the same. So this one's going to tweak a little bit this way.
So Maria, I'd like to know where you get your synthetic cotton.
The synthetic cotton I use comes from Albany Foam and Supply. And I also know that Genco Upholstery Supply carries it. So those are the two vendors that I know. If anybody out there watching has another supplier source for the synthetic cotton, go ahead and share that information.
Let's see, what about California?
California, there's Ronco Upholstery Supply, but I don't know if they carry synthetic or not. Who else is out there? I'm trying to think. You know how sometimes all of a sudden your mind goes blank? Well, that's what's happening. Come down. You know, I didn't check where it ended over there either. I'll have to look at that. Let's lock this for a second. And I'll come back and measure that point. Okay, I'm losing all my tools today. There it is. 6. Okay, now we are closer to 4 1/4. Let's see. It would be easier with a sock block tape measure, Kim. Why are you struggling? We got it! Yay! Okay. Now let's look at the bottom. So at the bottom here, just as I start to bend around the corner, I've got a partial smidge of a black diamond. And it ended up the same. We are in luck. So the rest of the way it worked out. I had a feeling that we'd get to the bottom edges and that would be different too, but we did not, so that's awesome. Right, so now, let me spin this a little bit. I think that is it. Let's go ahead and get a staple in there and then I'll check the other side. There to the point. is about 5/8. Let me just measure over here. Boy, I'm good. We got them exactly the same. That's good. Sometimes you do these things and you think they're going to be exactly the same and they are not. So now I think we are ready to go ahead and fill this in with staples down both sides, add our cardboard tack strip, and then pat it, and then we'll deal with how we're going to end the bottom. And I'm just going to let the fabric fold on its the way it wants to fold and let the diamonds grow gradually. Let's flip this all the way up so I don't yank it out of place here. I'm going to go do the same thing over here. Again, I'm just following down on that fold line that I've created with my fingernails. Cut off some of this excess up here and get our cardboard tack strip going, add a piece, go all the way down towards the bottom. And actually, I did not get a staple down here at the corner. I'm just continuing this piece down and we'll add more cardboard tack strip as we go. And over here I didn't leave quite as much extra, so we're going to be adding it right away on this side. I may have to redo a room just for this chair. Right, Bill?
Well, we could put it in our kitchen because it matches the floor.
Oh, that's true. Our floor has the squares. Are they squares or are they diamonds?
Well, diamonds if you, yeah, depends on how you look at it.
Depends on how you look at it. They are diamonds, now that you say that, yeah. You know how it is? You live with something and you're like, what does that look like? Okay, yeah. Piece of cardboard.
I know the feel.
Hey, wait a minute. I don't think he's talking about furniture here.
You're always gone. I wonder what you look like.
Sorry. I'm traveling teaching. And next week I head out to Rochester, New York. You probably saw the post that I shared of Debbie's chair that she is doing for the workshop, the wingback chair that she was tearing down. I'm just going to have to tie springs, lots and lots of springs.
Speaking of chairs, how many saw the post that Carly Millicon put out there with her new chair? Huh?
Oh, Carly Melanson, yeah.
Melanson, sorry about that.
I'm trying to remember when she posted that out there. Oh, yeah, it was just this morning we saw it. So I don't know if any of you follow the Desert Canary. If you don't, you should. But she put a picture out there this morning, earlier today, I don't know exactly what time. There was a wingback chair, and the before was the first picture, which was a navy blue and off-white check. But then if you open up and look at the rest of the pictures and see the process, how she made her decisions for the fabric, it is absolutely stunning. It totally blows my mind, the combinations of fabric she puts together. Because if you laid them on a table, I think a lot of us would just walk away and say, yeah, not so much. But when she gets them on those pieces of furniture, they're absolutely gorgeous. And then the outsides, she actually embossed fabric over the top of the animal. I think, look, it was a fur on fur, or a fur on hide skin, wasn't it, I think?
I think so, yeah.
And then she had like made cactuses out of what looks like it might be a vinyl or a faux suede over the top of it. So they're actually sewn on, and then somehow she's got
studs around. They need to go look.
Yeah, you gotta go look. It's absolutely gorgeous. So Desert Canary. Yeah, I was going through all the pictures. It's just like, and I actually get to meet her in person in October, which will be fun. She's attending the workshop. Workshop I'm teaching in Corpus Christi, Texas. Okay, I'm not gonna staple that very bottom piece yet. Let's go get the other side stapled down. And then we'll take a peek at everything before we add padding and fill it in with more staples. Now, somebody was asking me once about recently about the cardboard tack strip and if you could find heavier cardboard tack strip. They make one, unless somebody knows of others that I don't know of. This one is, I mean, I'm terrible with that, but probably like a 16th of an inch thick. And then they have one, and I forget what they call it, but it's like really heavy and it's more like working with a piece of wood, and it's not, I don't like it at all. So this stuff is what I use all the time for cardboard tack strip. And even though it's flexible and it can bend easy, it still is great stuff. I don't really think you need anything heavier. And I'm not quite sure what you use the heaviest stuff for.
They won't know until they try, though.
Right, yeah. So
Tasha loves the colors. Let's see, Crystal joined us. Annette wants to know if you got what you wanted from Trish.
We're still working together, Annette, and thank you very much. I think we are going to be very happy with what she comes up with.
Jenny likes your button placement.
Likes the button placement, is that what you said? Okay. And I just made a boo-boo with a staple, so I had to remove that.
Kirk loves the chair and the buttons are perfect.
Thank you. I'm glad everybody likes that. I wasn't sure when I first started putting them on. It's still this camera, right, Bill?
Let me take a peek. Yeah.
Okay. At one point, I was thinking of not adding any buttons. And I went back and forth between the white and the black, but I really like the idea of the black.
Sylvie likes the buttons and she thinks they're gradually bigger diamond. Yeah, I like that too.
Okay.
Bonnie says perfect. And refresh Sylvia's memory. Are you doing the black and white on the outside? Yes.
Yes. And now I'm just kind of looking at how this is going to fall. And I think I'm just going to leave this stuff all like hanging a mess until we get the cotton in there, because the padding is going to affect how I finish this edge off as far as like cutting the fabric back. So any other comments I need to? You can get synthetic. That's right. You cannot get synthetic cotton in California. I forgot about that. California's regulations don't allow them to use synthetic cotton or the sagless fabric. It's on my list to attend one of your workshops. Well, I hope you will get to attend one someday. I would love to meet you in person with your pink hair. Do you have pink hair still? Hello, Carmelina. And James says, we use the heavy cardboard rolls on straight lines on the top of some of our 40 by 40 ottomans. Okay. That makes sense. That does make sense. Yeah. Yeah, because you're not bending it and shaping it. That makes really good sense. Okay. Now, I'm going to, what was I doing? I forgot what I was doing. All right, we're pulling it back to take a peek before I go any further to make sure everything looks good. And then we will go ahead and fill in with staples. Excuse me while I'm on my tippy toes here to see the top of the chair. And down the side. Guys, I'm really liking this. What do you guys think? I think this is really fun.
Hey. Well, I suggested it.
Yes, Bill did suggest this. I have to give the man credit. Okay, geez, I have to share the fun with you. Originally, we were trying to decide whether to do this with a contrast here or not. He had wanted it further on the front of the chair, which I didn't understand until I was gone too far, and he's like, that's not what I meant. And then afterwards, I'm like, oh, now I get what you're talking about. But at one point, I had thought of just bringing the blue all the way around and not having any contrast along the top edge, and I'm glad he talked me into doing that. So let's go ahead and fill her in with staples. We need to name our chair. She needs a name, or he.
Alice?
For Alice in Wonderland? What was the name? Let's see, what are some of the other names from Alice in Wonderland besides like the Mad Hatter? But actually, you know what? My cardboard tack strip. Okay, so here's a good little quick fix for you guys. So right here, I just noticed that my cardboard tack strip's close enough at the top, and it's close enough down here, but because of the shape, I missed like an eighth of an inch right there. So instead of having to pop this all out and shift it, I'm just going to take another piece of cardboard and bridge over the two pieces and bump it up to where I need it. Voila, and then it's done. So it just pushed it in that extra amount that I needed. And then I don't need it all the way down there, so I'll just tear that excess off. And that solves my problem. So now I'll go ahead and fill it in. Way to go, Bill, Bonnie says. Bill, welcome to the dark side. it's finishing an Allison. She's finishing an Alice chair right now. Okay, Tiffany. It reminds me of Tiffany Blue. That's a good one. Hello, Sandra. All right, let's go ahead and fill this in. Oops, and it helps that you don't run out of staples. Again, not going all the way to the bottom right yet. Okay, that's a lot of staples. My arm's getting tired. And there comes the air compressor. All right, so now I'm going to put, I'm trying to decide if I want just a layer of Dacron or if I want to bump it so it's a little bit rounded. I think I'll put a little piece of cotton and Dacron in here and see what it looks like before I commit. So I was trying to decide if I want it to just be, you know, smooth. The door just opened, so the air compressor got really loud. Just smooth with one layer, or if I want to kind of round it a little bit. This fabric tells me that it might not cooperate with rounding it because it doesn't have any stretch, this denim that I'm using. So let's play with a piece of scrap here and see what we're going to come out with. Scissors. If I do, and I'm just going to put a couple of temporary staples in here. So if I do, this is two layers of cotton, which I can already tell is probably going to be too much, but I'm going to try it. Temporary staple on either end. And then I take a piece of Dacron, which is a 1 ounce Dacron, so that's thick too. So that might be something I have to tear down. I'm wrapping it around. You know what? I can already tell I don't like that. That's too much. It's rounded so you can see it from the front better. Let me turn it so you guys can see it. Let's see what you think. I'm thinking it's too much. Let's get it in an angle that you can really see the effect from the front. Yeah, I don't even know if I can get that padding to stay in there. There's so much I've got, so I've definitely got too much. But, so that gives it kind of a bubbly, it's hard for you guys to tell on camera. But I'm already thinking, yeah, if you want to zoom in, let's see, I got to get it held in place again. I'd have to take some of it out anyway, but just to get it to not come onto the back. So that's a rounded, kind of a funky look. And you know what? It really distorts the bow tie effect. So I think that's a no. I'm not going to wait for your answer. Sorry, guys. Now let's pop this out and do one layer of Dacron, which I think is going to be the answer. Yeah, much cleaner, and it doesn't distort my bow ties. I'm looking at the screen to see what you guys see, see if you can see those or not. So I think that's the answer. I think I'm going to go with one layer of Dacron in here, and I think the full layer of Dacron is okay. I don't need to split it. So yeah, we'll be using...
Bonnie's saying flatter.
Yeah, it just was too bubbly, and it kind of killed the bow tie effect and had too fat of a tail on my bow tie. So let's go get some deeper on.
Carmelina says without padding.
All right, so I'm going to, let's see, am I gonna move this to the floor first? I think I'll start on the side first, and then we'll move it to the floor for the top after I get the sides done a little bit, because I can always pull that other fabric down after, so that will work out well. All right, now this is, what did I say, it was like 1 1/8 inch at the bottom, so I'm gonna go ahead and cut this into narrow strips. Actually, that edge is not square at all, so we'll go on this edge. And I'll just eyeball it, and then we'll trim down the excess. And don't cut your cloth tape measures, which is what happened to that one. It used to be 120 inches long, and it's now about 43.
Hello, Tammy Green. Haven't heard from you in quite a while.
Hey, Tammy. So there's one strip. Two strips. So did anybody come up with any more names besides Tiffany for the chair? Dodo.
Audrey, Dodo. I think those were maybe the only two.
Okay. Probably enough, but I'll cut one more just in case. Really have too much. This is just a scrap piece of dapron that I had hanging around, which it's always hard to find things to use your scraps for, but if you're working on like ottomans or situations where you get these tiny sections, sometimes you can use some of the scraps of it. Okay, toss that over there. All right, let's start on this side. Again, I'm not going to go all the way to the end yet. Make sure I catch my fabric. Which way do I need to go to untangle? This way.
Yep.
Here we go, looby-loo, here we go, looby-loo. All around the mulberry bush.
We need to put a connection right at the base of the thing so that you're never twisted.
Oh, so that it's hitched to the pedestal?
Yeah.
Can you guys see, or am I in your way? I think I'm in your way. I do not want my intersection to be right at the top, so I'm going to go up a little bit further and we'll hack this off and put another piece. I'd rather not have a seam right there, just in case. I think I can actually do from here, even though it's up high, maybe. Just going all the way across. I'm being careful not to catch my fabric in here when I'm stapling this to the cardboard tack strip. Now that little piece I cut off, I'll actually fill in this end over here.
Tammy, this is a chair we're doing as a tutorial.
Thank you. So now I'm going to go ahead and trim following the perimeter of the chair, getting rid of the excess because I don't want any on the back side. So bear with me while I do the boring stuff and just cut here. See, I need another staple there, so yeah, pull it off too much. Maybe it's not. Maybe it's just the way I was holding it. Because it seems like there's staples in there. Cutting Dacron with scissors along the edge of the chair sometimes is awkward. Around the top. Probably should have trimmed the diamond fabric before I did this. That's why I'm going through the Dacron and the diamond fabric that's hanging over. So it's a little thick in some spots. Especially around that corner where I had the double layer of the diamond fabric. It's getting there though. So after we do this part, what time is it? Oh my goodness, it's almost 1:30 already. Yikes. The next thing is to put on the welt cord on the outside of the frame. And then next week we'll put the diamonds on the outside back and the outside arms. So next week I don't leave till Thursday for the workshop, so we will still be live on Wednesday. Okay. Trim a little closer over here, I think. I think we got it. Let's start going and working this around. So I'm just going to be pulling. I don't know where the best view is for you guys. Almost tangled it up again. So I'm just going to start pulling this towards the back, making sure I keep my padding where I want it. Stapling it to the outside back of the chair. On the pedestal would be helpful. You don't need any chairs crashing to the floor. Then I'll be like, Bill, we need a repair. And we actually were working on a project yesterday that we're doing for another tutorial. It's got a different deck. It's a T deck, but I'm doing it a different way than anything we have in our membership yet. So that'll be fun for you guys to see. So it's actually a boxed deck. And it has a tufted inside back. It's got a few button details that are a little different too. Get a couple more staples in here and then I'll turn it so you guys can see this edge. I have to figure out the bottom. Let's see here. That's gonna be fun. Let's see. I know it's, I don't know if you can zoom in, Bill. That doesn't show from there, but that's really cute with the little bow ties.
Where do you want to see that?
The area over here on the side. What's the pink thing? Oh, it's the ruler sticking out in the back. It's distracting from it. Let's see if I turn it. Yeah, it's really hard. We'll have to put a close-up picture out on Facebook later for you guys. But you can see the little bow ties when you look at it from the front. It's really cute. All right, so we are at the end of the hour here. So I will go ahead and finish doing this part of the chair and get the cording on the outside. And then that way next week when we come back, we'll start right in with curvies and the outside back fabrics. So thank you guys all for joining us today. We really appreciate you coming and spending this hour with us. Go ahead and hit that share button if you haven't already. And for those of you that are members, we will be live for our members Q&A at 3 o'clock this afternoon, which is about an hour and a half. So we are going to go grab lunch and we'll see you guys at 3 o'clock. So thanks again, everybody.